We have been so caught up in the quotidian day-to-day challenges of governing Nigeria that we have failed to define an overarching vision for the people. We do not have an articulated vision for Nigeria. None has been presented. And without a vision, the people must perish. Let it, however, be known that a vision for Nigeria will not be accomplished without intellect. And this underscores the importance of education. Successful nationhood is highly dependent on the caliber of intellect applied, the ability to process thoughts, apply the faculty of imagination, mind data, and see the pattern in facts. Applied intellect requires comparative analysis, development of best case scenarios, adaptation of best practices, and determination of a nation's comparative and competitive advantages. Intellect is so critical in the development of a nation. I do get worried, however, at the idea of an unthinking, unanalytical, unreasoning, unquestioning, unreading generation of Christians who devote themselves to motivational books and nothing more. After you've been motivated, what next? To succeed as a leader, you must be well-versed and well-read. You must have a working knowledge of economics, political science, philosophy, and sociology. And if you aspire to lead a multi-religious and multicultural entity like Nigeria, you require a fair grasp of comparative theology of the three main religions. But we are jumping ahead of ourselves in several aspects. Let us now begin with the fundamentals. That was just introduction. Nigeria is a very rich country. It is one of the most endowed nations on earth. It is bound in the west by a nation called Benin Republic, on the east by Cameroon, on the north by Chad and Niger, and on the south by a vast expanse of ocean. Nigeria has a huge land mass. It is 923,768 square kilometers. The nation can roughly be bifurcated into two atmospheric entities: the rainforest south, where we are now, and the Sahel north. This should be an important consideration for power generation and agricultural endeavor, but things don't always follow the path of reason in Nigeria. Common sense dictates that the northern part of Nigeria should be dependent on solar energy. The conditions are perfect for solar power generation, whilst hydroelectric power is ideal for the south. In terms of agriculture, Nigeria houses the climatic conditions of the top 10 agricultural exporting nations in the world by produce. The northwest is China. The northeast is Mexico. The north central is Brazil and Argentina. The middle belt is Sierra Nevada foothills in California. The southwest is Ghana and Cote d'Ivoire combined. The southeast is Malaysia and Jamaica. And the south-south is Thailand. In 2008, these nations earned in excess of $74 billion from agricultural exports. In other words, Nigeria can potentially earn more from agriculture. But then the question arises, with such climatic blessedness, how come people are hungry in Nigeria? A confluence of two great rivers created an artificial boundary between the south and the north. It also divided the south into two, creating the east and the west. There is thus the southwestern expanse of land and the southeastern expanse of land, as well as the northern expanse of land. But in truth, this is a simplistic configuration, which unfortunately has sometimes been carried too far. The idea of a Muslim north and a Christian south is a lie perpetuated for geopolitical purposes.